Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Mass for the fourth Sunday of Ordinary Time. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Friends, we read in the Gospel today that Jesus spoke with authority. His words made things happen in the people who heard them, changing their lives forever. And today we await his words and we embrace them, for they change our lives forever as well. Lord Jesus, our teacher, you are the cause of all our joy and thanksgiving. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, our teacher, you are the light of the world. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, our teacher, you preach the good news of salvation to all. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all of our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to all the people, saying, "A prophet like me will the Lord your God raise up for you from among your own kin. To him you shall listen. This is exactly what you requested of the Lord your God at Horeb on the day of the assembly, when you said, "Let us not again hear the voice of the Lord our God, nor see this great fire anymore, lest we die." And the Lord said to me, "This was well said. I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their kin, and will put my words into his mouth. He shall tell them all that I command him. Whoever will not listen to my words which he speaks in my name, I myself will make him answer for it. But if a prophet presumes to speak in my name an oracle that I have not commanded him to speak, or speaks in the name of other gods, he shall die." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The words for our response today are taken from Psalm 95. If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I should like you to be free of anxieties. An unmarried man is anxious about the things of the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But a married man is anxious about the things of the world, how he may please his wife, and he is divided. An unmarried woman or a virgin is anxious about the things of the Lord, so that she may be holy in both body and spirit. A married woman, on the other hand, is anxious about the things of the world, how she may please her husband. I am telling you this for your own benefit, not to impose a restraint upon you, but for the sake of propriety and adherence to the Lord without distraction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Then they came to Capernaum, and on the Sabbath, Jesus entered the synagogue and taught. The people were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. In their synagogue was a man with an unclean spirit. He cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Quiet, come out of him." The unclean spirit convulsed him and with a loud cry came out of him. All were amazed and asked one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority. He commands even the unclean spirits and they obey him." His fame spread everywhere throughout the whole region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Many years ago, a student came into my classroom and gave me this little thing here, a gift to me from his parents. An uncle of theirs had been a Secret Service man stationed at the White House and had given it to them, and then it showed up with me here. It's just a little old ink blotter. That's all it is. It doesn't look like very much, and it isn't very much, but it does represent authority, the theme of today's gospel, to a degree, earthly authority, which comes and goes. Up close, you can see the signature several times over of Franklin Roosevelt. And I often wonder what he signed those days when this blotter was used. Maybe it was something about the Depression. Maybe it was something about the war effort, probably was, some of them, or a letter to a family that lost a soldier. It could have been the day he signed Social Security that so many of you receive today. That was during his time. And there was one thing he signed that was a sad mistake. When we took the Japanese Americans in California and housed them in a special place, they were American citizens, but we were afraid with the war on. So I don't know, no one will ever know, but it represents his authority, at least for a while. There are many kinds of authority. When I was assigned to the cathedral, I was told, never sit in the bishop's chair. You can walk by it, you can look at it, but you're not to sit in it. The word cathedral means chair. And so if he were to put his chair here, this becomes the cathedral. And so the bishop has authority over 11 counties in Michigan and the Catholics in them, and it's represented by that chair. When he comes to this church 2 weeks from yesterday to have the 5 o'clock mass, he's going to be wearing this zucchetto back here, and when they bring up the bread and wine, he will take it off and set it aside. And it's a beautiful lesson, really. It means the Lord is coming. The Lord is coming to this altar. And so this has to be taken off until the Mass is almost completed. This represents his authority, too. When he comes 2 weeks from yesterday, and if you happen to see him, you don't have to tell him that I have this. And he might ask questions and wonder what this is all about. It's just a prop for a homily, that's all. And so that represents authority too. Policemen have authority. When Officer Jeff Brown stopped me one day here in Mount Pleasant, I recognized his authority to do so. And of course, he could decide if I had a ticket coming or if he would let me go with a lecture. But he had authority, and I recognized it, that's for sure. But you know, did you notice all these are for a temporary time? They come and they go. Other bishops come, other policemen come, other places become cathedrals. And so it's all temporary here on this earth. But authority is a very prominent word today in the gospel. But it's different because it's forever. That's the big difference. And so we read that Jesus spoke with authority. And we also read that his readings and his words kept them spellbound and in awe. His authority and his word are forever. Think of your ancestors, not just 100 years ago, those way back, 400 years ago, 600 years ago. You don't know who they are, none of us do, but they heard these same words way back then and found courage from them all. And they were spellbound by them too and placed all their hopes in them. So in every age, people have been inspired, they've been given hope, and they persevere in their life, whether it's hard or not, all because he spoke with authority. So those words are given a prominent place. Did you notice, it's automatic, we don't think about it, but the word is here from this pulpit, or ambo. It's given a special place of its own in addition to the altar to proclaim the word from here. And that, of course, is because they are so important to us. Why were they spellbound? Well, they had never heard anything like them before. When Peter thought he was doing everything proper, forgiving 7 times, Jesus says 77 times, meaning always. Jesus says, don't judge like you've been judging. There's only one judge who matters. Serve one another, not just your relatives or your kinsmen. Be single-hearted and love your neighbor, but also love your enemy. We know those words are words of truth, but they're very difficult to live out. And so we come here for strength and courage to live them. Bishop Untener once said that when we gather on a Sunday morning like this, we become an orchestra. We're an orchestra. He said, all play different instruments, but everybody's needed. What he meant was we're of different backgrounds and races and nationalities, young and old and middle-aged, and we come and share the word and share the Eucharist, and we're strengthened by the Holy Spirit. And as a result, he said, we make beautiful music for the Lord. You and I, when we come here in a big number like this, we make beautiful music for the Lord. So we're gathered as an orchestra this morning, practicing our faith, listening, receiving him as one single body of Christians. And the Holy Spirit does the rest. And the Holy Spirit changes the bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ. And so he changes us too, gathered together like we are. So I hope you're spellbound and in awe. I hope that never leaves any of us. When the word is spoken, and because of what happens in this building. So yes, there's a lot of examples of authority, a policeman with his or her badge, a judge with his or her gavel, a bishop with his chair, or the zucchetto in this case, and even the President of the United States for a little while, represented today by that simple little ink blotter. All that comes and goes. So you and I follow the author of everything we are. Did you notice author and authority are the same root word? He's the author of everything we are and everything we're going to become too. And we call him teacher. He's called teacher in scriptures 47 times. One who teaches with authority. So I hope we're all spellbound. I hope we're in awe at the wisdom and truth and life of his words and his actions. For his words and actions truly are for you and for me, spirit and life itself. We stand to recite the Nicene Creed together. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In faith and in trust, we bring our prayers and our needs now to the Lord.
For our church throughout the world, may we all bear the mystery of Jesus' authority to love and serve people in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and harmony among all nations, that we will come to realize that we are all sons and daughters of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people suffering in mind, body, and spirit, may they experience the healing power of Jesus' mercy and grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
As we celebrate Catholic Schools Week throughout the United States, may we continue to follow Jesus, the way, the truth, and the life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our teachers, parents, administrators, students, and all school personnel, may God continue to bless them in their mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And for those intentions that we hold in our hearts today, that we now hand over to the Lord in silence. For these we pray to the Lord. God of glory, hear our prayers this morning for all who are in need. Bring forth the good things that only you can do in our lives through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our presentation hymn is number 728, Eye Has Not Seen, 728.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of bread and wine and of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while we are in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Robert our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, for family members who come to mind. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and gracefully and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us share with one another a sign of the Lord's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
number 683, Be Not Afraid, 683.
You do not know the way.
throughout the United States, this is Catholic School Week beginning on this Sunday, and many activities are planned in all the schools throughout the country, including Sacred Heart Academy. And for a brief time, the principal of the school and one of the students would like to come up at this time and just say a little bit about the Academy, which has existed since 1889.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm Mary Kay Yonker, the principal of Sacred Heart Academy, and I would just like to share a few words about Catholic Schools Week and Sacred Heart Academy. National Catholic Schools Week is the annual celebration of Catholic education in the United States, and it always begins the last Sunday in January. The theme for 2024 is Catholic Schools, United in Faith and Community. What is special about Sacred Heart Academy? We offer an education that combines Catholic faith and teachings with academic excellence. We partner with parents in the faith formation of their children. We set high standards for student achievement and we help them succeed. We provide a balanced academic curriculum that integrates faith, culture, and life. We use technology effectively to enhance our instruction, and we instill in our students the value of service to others. We have a graduation requirement of 100 service hours, but many of our students far double that. We emphasize moral development and self-discipline. We prepare students to be productive citizens and future leaders. We have a graduation rate of 100%. The average in the state of Michigan is 81%. We cultivate a faculty and staff who are dedicated, caring, and effective. They are invested in our students, and they are the heart of our school. We provide a safe and welcoming environment. Most importantly, at Sacred Heart Academy, every student K-12 is taught Catholic values and religion every single day. Catholic schools are both a privilege and a sacrifice. We benefit all year long from religious guidance, support, and prayers that our parish provides. Sacred Heart Academy is one of only three K-12 schools in the state of Michigan supported by one parish. The other two schools are Gaylord St. Mary's and Lake Leelanau St. Mary's. We would not be here without the support of Sacred Heart Parish, and we appreciate the gifts and support that each of you provide to benefit our school. The success of our alumni speaks volumes. Sacred Heart Academy has been educating students since 1889, when the Dominican Sisters first opened the doors. We currently have 4,019 alumni. We've been educating students for 134 years and we have proven results. This Wednesday is the National Appreciation Day for Catholic Schools, and we would like the senior citizens in our parish to join our students for bingo from 9:30 to 10:30 in the parish hall. Now, we won't be checking IDs, so if you think you're a senior citizen and you like bingo, we hope you'll come and join us. We could not do anything without the very generous support of Sacred Heart Parish and our Sacred Heart Academy Foundation. And from the bottom of our hearts, we thank you. Now I'd like to introduce sophomore Savannah Jones to share a few words.
Hi, my name is Savannah and I'm a sophomore at Sacred Heart Academy. I've been very blessed to attend a Catholic school my whole life. Being a part of a community like Sacred Heart is something you can't find anywhere else, and I'm extremely grateful for the opportunity. I love the small classes and welcoming staff that make Sacred Heart feel like home, and I appreciate the extracurricular activities such as sports, service groups, and youth ministry. Opportunities to strengthen relationships with peers, teachers, coaches, and administrators are provided on a daily basis. But in addition to all of these, and more importantly, our education is centered around Christ. Not only are we able to receive the gift of the Eucharist and worship God with our school family in the middle of the week, we have models of faith in every area of our school. Our coaches, teachers, administrators, and those who work hard to provide lunches, cleanliness, and maintenance for us each day. So thank you to all of you who continue to support our Catholic education, whether spiritually, financially, or physically. We know truly that a Catholic education is a gift that will last a lifetime. Thank you.
I invite those who are going to take communion to the homebound to come up at this time. Father Lauren and I were talking the other day about, I wonder how many people are homebound or in convalescent homes from this parish. And all we could say was dozens and dozens and dozens because of the largeness of this parish. And so you do them a wonderful act of kindness today by bringing the Lord to them and by taking the news of our parish to them as well. And they feel much more a part of things when you do that. And we don't want to forget them. So may you be blessed in this wonderful work of yours today. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. There are just a couple of announcements today. There are two sure things in life. One of them is taxes. We are in tax preparation season now, and the parish administration has prepared your giving statements for those who have given $250 or more in 2023. After Mass, there will be a parish representative in the vestibule with your statement. By picking yours up in person, you are helping us to save postage. And on behalf of the parish, we want to thank everyone for your donations to Sacred Heart. And as part of celebrating Catholic Schools Week, Sacred Heart Academy students are providing refreshments in the vestibule after Mass today. This week in our church, we'll have Adoration of the Blessed Sacrament on Tuesday and Wednesday afternoons. Please see the bulletin for more detail. The Sacred Heart Women's Club is having a Euchre party this afternoon in the parish hall, beginning at 2:00. All are welcome. And lastly, Shigella raffle tickets are still being sold in the vestibule after Mass this weekend. The grand prize is $10,000. Proceeds benefit the Academy. May you have a very nice week ahead, and the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is number 622, Canticle of the Turning, 622.
Spirit sings of the wondrous things that you bring.